night head robs me of my rest. Love, hopeless love, my ardent soul encumbers. Love, nightmare-like, lies heavy on me chest. And weaves itself into my midnight slumbers. When you're lying awake with a dismal headache and reposes the mood by anxiety, I conceive you may use any language you choose to indulge in without impropriety. For your brain is on fire, the bedclothes conspire of usual slumber to plunder you. First your counterpane goes and uncovers your toes, and your sheet slips demurely from under you. Then the blanketing tickles, you feel like mixed pickles, so terribly sharp is the pricking. And you're hot and you're cross and you tumble and toss till there's nothing to cure the ticking. Then the bedclothes will creep to the ground in a heap and you pick them all up in a tangle. Next your pillow resigns and politely declines to remain at its usual angle. Will you get some repose in the form of a doze with hot eyeballs and head ever aching? But your slumbering teams with such horrible dreams that you'd very much better be waking. For you dream you are crossing the channel and tossing about in a steamer from Harwich, which is something between a large bathing machine and a very small second-class carriage. And you're giving a treat, penny ice and cold meat, to a party of friends and relations. They're a ravenous horde, and they all came on board at Sloane Square and South Kensington stations. And bound on that journey, you find your attorney who started that morning from Devon. He's a bit undersized, you don't feel surprised when he tells you he's only 11. Well, you're driving like mad with this singular lad, by the by, the ship's now a four-wheeler. And you're playing round games as he calls you bad names and you tell him that ties pay the dealer. But this you can't stand, so you throw up your hand and you find you're as cold as an icicle. In your shirt and your socks with black silk with gold clocks, crossing Salisbury Plain on a bicycle. And he and the crew are on bicycles too, which they've somehow or other invested in. And he's telling the tars all the particulars of a company he's interested in. It's a scheme of devices to get at low prices, all goods from cough mixtures to cables, which tickle the sailors by treating retailers as though they were all vegetables. You take a good spadesman to plant a small tree, but first take off his boots with a boot tree. And his legs will take root and his fingers will shoot, and he'll blossom and bud like a fruit tree. From the green goes a tree, you get grapes and big peacocks, cauliflower, pineapple and cranberries. While the pastry cook plant cherry brandy, will plant apple puffs and three corners and banberries. The shares are a penny and ever so many are taken by Rothschild and Baring. And just as if you were allotted to you, you awake with a shudder despairing. You're a regular wreck with a figure you'll never know. One of you is normal, your head's on the floor, but then your needles are pins and your soul's to your sins and your flesh is a pin for your left with your stick. You jump and your toes to fly. But the darkness has passed, and its day out at last, and the night has